Hi, this is Dan Brunton with the Intel Corporation. In this video, I'll review the basic steps needed to configure Intel EMA to manage Intel vPro devices at the hardware level. I won't go over the installation of Intel EMA in this video. We have other videos available that cover that topic. This video will start with the steps after you finish the installation. I'll go over the following: creating a tenant and users, setting up a basic Intel AMT configuration profile, creating an endpoint group, installing the Intel EMA agent on an Intel vPro client, and managing the client. I'll start with creating a tenant. We need to log into our new Intel EMA instance with a global administrator account. I'm using Intel EMA's built-in account management and created this account when I installed my server. Global admin accounts are for managing the Intel EMA server settings, managing tenants, and managing users. Global admins cannot manage endpoints. Let's create a tenant. You need to supply a name and description. Now that we have a tenant, we can create a tenant admin account. If I had more than one tenant, I would choose the correct one from the drop-down list. Click on the New User button and fill in the username as an email address. Description. Password. And select Tenant Administrator as the role. Now that we have a Tenant Admin created, we can log out as the Global Admin and log back in with the Tenant Admin account I just created. I like to start by creating an Intel AMT configuration profile. Click the new Intel AMT profiling to get started. I'll supply a name and description. Next, we need to choose the communication method. I'm going to stick with the default option to always use client-initiated remote access. In this mode, Intel AMT will be told the host name of the Intel EMA instance and will initiate a connection to it. Next, I'll go to Management Interfaces. This is where you can choose the Intel AMT capabilities you want to enable. Note some features, like one-click recovery and remote platform erase, may only be available on newer devices. I'm going to check off everything, including user consent. I'm going to be using host-based configuration, also known as client control mode, when configuring Intel AMT in this demo. So, even if I left user consent unchecked, it would be enabled anyway. We'll talk more about control modes later in the video. Next, I'll configure some basic Wi-Fi settings. I'll enable Wi-Fi profile synchronization, Wi-Fi management in all power states, and BIOS Wi-Fi profile sharing. It's important to note that Wi-Fi profile synchronization between the host and Intel AMT does not support 802.1x authentication. You need to create an Intel AMT Wi-Fi profile if you use 802.1x authentication in your environment. We'll save this profile and move on to the next step. Now that we have a basic Intel AMT profile created, we can create an endpoint group. Fill in the group name and description. Enter the group password. As of the creation of this video, this password is used for some internal security purposes, but does not yet allow you to modify the endpoint group. Now I will select the capabilities I want to enable for software level management. Now that I have my endpoint group's configuration set, I'll move on to configuring Intel AMT's auto setup options. I'll start by enabling auto setup for my endpoint group. I would use this drop-down menu to select my Intel AMT profile if I had more than one. My only activation method available is host-based. If I upload an Intel AMT provisioning certificate to my Intel EMA tenant, I would be able to choose TLS PKI provisioning, also known as admin control mode. Let's take a moment to briefly discuss the Intel AMT activation methods. Intel EMA supports activating Intel AMT in two modes, client control mode with host-based provisioning, and admin control mode with TLS PKI provisioning. There are two main differences between these modes. Client control mode does not require a certificate to provision Intel AMT, but makes user consent mandatory for capabilities listed on the screen. Admin control mode requires purchasing a provisioning certificate from a third-party CA and makes user consent optional. Let's shift back to Intel EMA. If I was setting up a production environment, I'd randomize the administrator password. However, for my testing purposes, a strong standardized password will make things easier. I'll save this, and we'll continue. Now we're ready to deploy the Intel EMA agent to a test endpoint. I'll start by downloading the agent files here in the Intel EMA web interface. I need to download both files to install the agent. We have the agent file itself and the configuration file that goes with it. I've copied the files I downloaded to my test system and will now install the agent. I need to run the agent installer executable as administrator. From here, I just click the install button and wait a moment. The installer will automatically close when it's done. Let's go back to the Intel EMA web interface and check if our endpoint has appeared. We can track the Intel AMT configuration status by viewing the details for the endpoint. Here I can see that Intel AMT is pending configuration. We'll give it a few minutes to finish and then refresh the page. Now that Intel AMT is provisioned, we are all set. Let's check out the Hardware Manageability tab. Let's start a KVM remote control session. I'll do that by going to the Remote Desktop menu option and clicking Connect. You can see the User Consent option has appeared. If I go to the client, you can see a 6-digit code on the screen that I need to enter into Intel EMA. Normally, this would be read to me over the phone by the person I'm assisting. Now that I've entered the 6-digit code, I'm connected. That's it. We're all set to manage this endpoint through hardware and software. If you'd like to learn more about the Intel vPro platform and Intel EMA, visit intel.com/vPro.